Good morning, friends. I'm Umesh Chukran, Assistant Lecturer at Chitkara School of Hospitality. And today's topic is Chef's Uniform. In our previous topics, we have read about the Introduction to Culinary and Food Production Department, in which we read what are the skills which are required to be a chef and what are the hygiene standards that a chef needs to maintain in the kitchen premises. In Chef's Uniform and in this chapter, we'll be reading about the different parts of dresses or the uniform that a chef wear in the kitchen premises. About the scope or the objective of this chapter, it is solely based on to know about the different parts of chef's uniform and to identify each of them, their uses in the kitchen and what safety purposes they signify or fulfill, and a brief history about the chef's uniform. So if we talk about the history of a chef's uniform, it starts from the catering establishment in different hotels and restaurants in the 1700 century. But before starting that, we should know that a chef's uniform in French language is also known as robe de chef. As we already know that every catering establishment or a restaurant or a hotel requires a specific uniform to represent their employees working in different departments, be it housekeeping, F&B services or kitchen. It should be uniform for everyone working in a department. It should also resemble or signify the department he or she is working, the specific purpose which the uniform fulfills, whether it is protective or not, because each uniform should be made in such a way that it should provide protection, and it should also be ergonomically matching with the employee's work area. It should also be hygienic in working style. It should be worn in such a way that it would go hand in hand with the employee. It should not produce any hindrance while he or she is working, and ease of work. If we talk about what are the parts or what does a chef's uniform consists of, it starts from headwear, that is chef cap, scarf or neckerchief, name tag, which is optional in many departments and different hotels. Then chef's jacket, apron, chef pant and chef shoes. Apart from chef's uniform, personal grooming is as important as a uniform is, and it contains well-trimmed hair, well-trimmed nails, no earpins for female staff, no fancy bangles or no fancy items that could become a contaminant for food. If we talk about the history of chef's uniform, it was started by Chef Antoine Marie Carrie in 19th century, or it can be said that in the initial stages of 19th century or in the initial years of 19th century, Antoine Marie Carrie brought up the idea of depicting chef in a specific uniform. It is already a standard in many food industries and many food related businesses. Now talking about the chef's uniform, the first part of it consists of chef cap or toque blanc. It is a white colored hat which is worn in the head to safeguard any hair fall in the food to become a contaminant. It is usually of white color. However, in many restaurant or many specific restaurant or food outlet, it can be used or it can be worn in different colors. It is usually braided or with plaits, which depicts the ways in which a chef can cook an egg or the ways in which an egg can be cooked by a chef. Then it also fulfills the hygienic purpose, as we already discussed, that it prevents any hair fall to make the food contaminated. It is protective. It saves our head from high temperatures or heat. Then comes the white necktie or handkerchief or a kitchen scarf. It is made up of anti-perspiring material, which also saves our body parts from the sweat falling from our head and neck. It is usually folded or made by the chefs itself, but nowadays it is coming in the self-folded option also. It is also available in different colors or provided to different levels of chef to signify their level or to differentiate them from each other. Then name tag, which is optional, which is usually sewed on the dress, or sometimes it is a magnetic tag which is given to the employees, which is worn on the left side of your jacket. Then comes chef coat, which is also known as veste blanc. It is usually double breasted fulfill the purpose that if it one of the side gets dirty, then it can be buttoned to the other side. It is usually white in color to reflect that a chef is working in a hygienic environment and in a clean environment. Usually, to executive chefs, black color coats or black color vestibular is also provided. Then its material is made in such a way that it makes it comfortable for a chef to work. And already, as I already told you, that it is double-breasted or double-buttoned. Next is apron, which is also a protective cloth for a chef, because in the case of a spillage, it saves the chef from any spillage or burning. It should be usually long enough to cover up the knees, but not that much long that it would reach to the foot. Then comes dishcloth or duster, which is also an integral part of this uniform. However, in some hotels or in many hotels, paper dusters are used, which do not cover up the part of the uniform. It is also known as torchon or dishcloth. It is used for cleaning purpose and also used to pick the hot objects or hot utensils. And then in the part of uniform, trousers is a word, is a part of uniform that is worn by the many chefs, and it is usually checkered. Its appearance should be clean. Whenever it gets dirty, it should be changed. The purpose why it is checkered is that it reflects that a chef uniform is indeed clean, and if some dirt is fallen on it, it would not be easily visible. As the ending part of our chef uniform, it is the safety shoes that also cover up our foot, which are made up of anti-slip, anti-skid and steel toe material. In many restaurants, clogs are also worn. However, they are not that much good to safeguard our shoes, to safeguard our foot, I'm sorry. And with this slide, we would end up our presentation with some rules which a chef's dress fulfills or which we must follow to keep our chef's dress hygienic and clean. Starting from the coat, apron and necktie, they should be changed at least once a day. Then the hat or chef's cap or trousers, they are also changed whenever they become dirty. The uniform, it must be worn in the kitchen premises only, and it should be avoided to wear a uniform or a kitchen uniform while traveling or in buses or trains. The uniform should always be washed and ironed before wearing again. Thank you with the last slide, and I hope you might have learned about the chef's uniform and its parts in our chapter, Chef's Uniform.